The Buddha named the Venerable Maha Moggallana the foremost monk in psychic powers. He was second in psychic powers only to the Buddha. Once on an Uposatha day, the Buddha sat silently in front of the assembly of monks. At each watch of the night, Ananda requested him to recite the Patimokkha, the code of monastic discipline, but the Buddha remained silent. Finally, when dawn came, the Buddha said, "This assembly is impure." Then, the Venerable Maha Moggallana used his mind to scan the entire assembly. By doing so, he was able to find the monk that was immoral, wicked, lustful, and corrupt. Then, the Venerable Maha Moggallana went to the monk and asked him to leave, but he refused. He had to be asked 3 times. Finally, the Venerable Maha Moggallana took him by the arm and led him out of the hall. In another instance, when Sariputta and Moggallana were sitting together, Sariputta commented that he found Moggallana to have a strikingly serene expression. Moggallana explained that he had just had a conversation with the Buddha. Sariputta remarked that the Buddha was currently very far away. Sariputta asked if the Buddha had come to visit Moggallana, or if Moggallana had used his powers to go see the Buddha. Moggallana said, "Neither." They had both directed their divine eyes and divine ears toward each other, and engaged in a Dhamma talk over long distances. The Venerable Maha Moggallana was also able to see and hear spirits in heaven, hell, and on earth. He could speak to them, and they could speak to him. They often brought him messages and warnings. On one occasion, the Venerable Sariputta was sitting in contemplation when a yaka, a malicious demon spirit, decided to hit him on the head with a great blow. Immediately after, the yaka was swiftly taken to hell, while the Venerable Sariputta, unable to see the yaka, wondered what had just happened. Afterwards, Sariputta met his friend Moggallana, who asked how he was. Sariputta responded that he was generally well and just had a slight headache. Moggallana then praised Sariputta's concentration and self-control. Sariputta then said, "How marvelous! You could see the yaka while I couldn't. Your abilities truly are remarkable." The Venerable Maha Moggallana often used his divine eye to see how karma operated and the fruit it bore. He clearly saw that human beings that practiced charity and restraint from evil were then reborn into heavenly realms. In contrast, he saw that those who committed evil deeds and harmed others were reborn in undesirable hell realms, where they would be tormented for long periods of time. He used his knowledge of karma to help persuade people to follow the right path. By doing so, they could avoid self-destruction through evil actions. The Buddha once astrally traveled to the heaven of the 33 to give a Dhamma sermon to the spirit of his deceased mother over a period of 3 earth months. During that time, the Venerable Maha Moggallana would astrally travel to the heaven of the 33 to give the Buddha an update as to what was happening with the Sangha, or the order of monks. Another time, while the Buddha brought 500 monks with him to visit the heaven of the 33, the whole group passed by the palace of a great and powerful naga, Nando Pananda. This royal naga was infuriated that the Buddha caused his palace to shake as he passed over it. Seeking revenge, Nando Pananda transformed himself into a gigantic serpent and coiled around Mount Sineru, causing darkness to cover much of the world. Several monks asked the Buddha for permission to subdue the malicious naga. However, because the Buddha knew of the royal naga's immense power, it was only when Maha Moggallana asked for permission that the Buddha granted it. The Venerable Maha Moggallana transformed himself into an even larger serpent and coiled around Nando Pananda 3 times. They had a vicious battle of psychic powers, using fire and smoke. Each of Nando Pananda's attacks harmlessly passed through the Venerable Maha Moggallana. However, when the Venerable Maha Moggallana sent fire and smoke towards Nando Pananda, it shattered the naga's massive defense. At this point, Nando Pananda knew he was bested, so he transformed back into his naga form and paid his respects to the great elder. The Buddha then praised Maha Moggallana as being foremost of all monks in psychic powers.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.